profession, professional will give salary, then promotion, then richness and luxury. So the ultimate end of a person to be happy, comfortable and self-propellant, for that an unavoidable step is their education. So intolerance, this must be, as a crucial surgery, it must be undergone by each and every people. So this real taste by which we make it rejoiceable, that is also a portion of intellect. So the link to know everything is curiosity, loving each and every word that you read, like your cinema songs and cricket datas, loving them, rejoiceable knowledge. Number two, keeping everything automatically in your mind, capable of instantaneous these are all the parts of memory which are the parts of intellect. So that is instantaneous imbibition, unfading retention, spontaneous reproduction and application is a skill of memory. These three components, they constitute the memory. So memory is not only studying everything. Whenever you want, you must be able to reproduce it either in the same way or in a descriptive or even more ornamental way. Just merely repeating the same thing makes no difference. It must be as the contribution of your own caliber and acumen. So likewise, these things are there in memory, but not there in the long-term memory. So this instantaneous process is not available because of human beings, you know, that to just begin to crawl, then begin to walk, then to run and to ride, it takes the biological development itself, in physical functions, it takes some time. So machines, they don't take some time. You prepare something for 15 days, you feed it, to reproduce it within a fraction of a second, it can be done. So the memories which are available in the computer system, computer is nothing but the replica of a seer's brain. There must be something which is known as divitulya, that which is having a celestial equivalent, which is called as a celestial equivalent. Whatever we have read about the sages, that they had everything in their memory. Just as it has been told by some sages about the ancient seers, that they have churned the ocean of knowledge by their tongues. Just as by Mandragiri and Vasuki, the milky ocean was churned, they have churned the knowledge, all disciplines of wisdom by the tongue, like Mandragiri. Likewise, those people, those who are having, these are the qualities of machine. Now, you see, gratitude is a quality of a human being. We cannot just deny it. But now the example is only our dog. Some domesticated animals, you see that they don't move away, they are very much affectionate to us. And ferocity and bravery is also with us. Now you see, for each and every example, no human being is quoted, only animals and flowers or something like this. So whatever we have in computer, one, data acceptance. Second, data processing as per the command. Number three, data retention. Number four, data reproduction. Number five, by artificial intelligence, data analysis, categorization and suggestive principles. Everything, all these things totally, that was nothing but a parcel or fragment of the brain of the ancient seer. So now we have to see the seer, the great seers like Vasishtha, Vyasa, Bhrigu, Atri, Vatsa, Khandva, we have to see, we can see them in the non-living instantiate form, the form of supercomputers or mega computers. So now it has, so it is your quality, whatever you are having in the computer, your quality that has been well placed in an organized structure, and because of your unorganized structure, it cannot be placed inside you. And even though you need not, you see, there are three things. One is memory, and second is inference and analysis, and third thing is reference. I do not say that everything you must have by memory. You must not keep it in memory. What are all the laundry products that you have given for the past 3 months? Somebody says that I keep in memory everything. So what do you have? I know all the grocery lists that I have purchased for the recent 6 months. What is your memory? So there are something which are known as exhausting memories. Just as you use it, just disperse it, number one. Number second is quintessential memory. You use it and understand the essence of it and keep the essence only with you. Number three, let the things be separate from you. Whenever you want, you can go and get that. That is referential memory, either from persons or from books. Number four, retention. Something you must not forget, like satya, tapas, bhakti, you must not forget in your life. Keep it permanently in your retentive memory. So something from reference, something from retention, something by inference and analysis. Everything you must not be expecting that somebody will tell you. It is just like somebody asking, somebody gave 2 1 rupees and asked them to go and purchase brinjal and chili, for example. Then the fellow came and asked, which for brinjal and which for silly? These things are very silly. Lot of things are by our inference and analysis. So you classify, put a classification table, how much you can have from reference, how much you can have from your own self-analysis and inference, that is by assumption. How much you want it in retention, how much you have to exhaust, how much you can extract and hold. These five classifications you have to make in memory. You prepare somebody from here, you make everything very clear about your characteristic analysis. I am not talking about the social characters or your personalized characters. Just your instincts of color, taste, then allergy and other things, etc. Along with the five areas where you can put these five elements, so that you cannot see everything you put inside the recycle bin. Whatever that is required, that is filtered, that is for application, you put it here. But immediately, they are just remembering, see, lot of cinemas are there. They are remembering it with Dirgha Smriti. And whatever there that is in the examination or interview, immediately as they step outside the threshold of the office or examination hall, they have to forget it. And everything that they have studied will look like an alien to them immediately. They will promise, I have never seen this book at all. Somebody, you please classify and send, on the basis of which we can make a constructive program. So there are different types of consciousness. What is consciousness? I want to say now. I have already told, consciousness is the basic energy. I have already told when I was discussing about these things to Dr. Bhatkar, the matter and energy, spirit and consciousness, space and time. They are known as the Dvanda Trika. There are the three duels. Matter has energy, likewise the spirit has consciousness, and space and time, they are collateral. They are the members of the cosmic government. These six people, they rule the cosmos. Likewise, here the spirit has consciousness. Consciousness is known as Chaitanya. And this consciousness, just as there are in chemistry, you might have read about the destructive and fractional distillation of the main fossil elements, which will result in a lot of byproducts and residues. Likewise, consciousness is the Moola Vastu, or it is the inseparable, infinite Dharma Bhuta Jnana, or wisdom of the soul, the spirit's inseparable attribute, which in different areas. Likewise, if there is a small drop of Ganges, it is also known as Ganges. If you see the big Alaknanda or Bhagirathi, that is also Ganges. Quantitatively, they may be different, but qualitatively, they are from the same Ganges. Likewise, even a small thing that you remember as a memory, even though you do a small thing by your brain, which is an acumen, even though you do a small by your repetitive practice, which is a caliber, even though you do a small thing by the means of your acquaintance, a habit, do anything that is of your execution tools, that is dexterity, resulting in all these stages, they determine only parts and parcels of, they are the scintillations or fragments of a composite structure known as consciousness. Starting from, for example, one unit of consciousness makes you to see this and take this. It is a function, a dexterous of handling something. I am taking this and looking. This is also the function of a consciousness. But that is a function of a trivial level of consciousness. Infinitesimal consciousness. Infinitesimal consciousness, negligible consciousness, proportional consciousness, analytical consciousness, considerable consciousness, paraconsciousness, super consciousness, applied consciousness, academic consciousness, depending on various areas, the names, the nomenclature has been made. And on different has been made with the physical structure, clinical backgrounds or mental structures. For example, for an infant, what is the consciousness level? For an infant, the consciousness is unmanifested. For an ignorant person, the consciousness is unuploaded. Nobody has informed him or he has not approached the person. For a lunatic person, the consciousness network is disturbed. For a sleeping person, that is there in a state of drowsiness, that is in a state of stagnation, which is known as somnolence. Students of our normal socialized network of our society, the anti-socialized people, those who are isolated, those who are neglected, those who are abandoned, those who are considered as a tumor, rumor and night terror and mare for us, such people, if they are properly nourished by a person who can have the capability of changing them without he being changed to their other. Effective and hyper capable persons must approach those people and they